we will be performing eccentric neural grooving for wrist extension in the quadruped base position from both a unilateral and a bilateral setup. So bilateral simply means I'll be performing it with both wrists at the same time. Unilateral is one wrist at a time. So to set the position up, you're in your quadruped base position. I wanna make sure though that I'm not starting from my passive end range. You will move into your or near your passive end range. I wanna make sure that I start out of it a little bit so that I have good contraction capabilities, pressing down into the floor. So I'm acting like I'm pressing my palms down, creating wrist flexion. That contraction will contract everything on the bottom side of that forearm. I then move into wrist extension, creating the eccentric contraction. So I create tension and then put load while I create tension, stretch while I load, creating my eccentric neural grooving. So if I'm doing both hands at the same time, it's a bilateral setup. So I will start out of my end range, start driving not just my fingers, but my palms down as if I was going to flex my wrists. I will then just slowly move forward into more wrist extension while I maintain that contraction. That's going to eccentrically load the forearms, find my end range position, and then I'll just shift my body back, come out of that position. So we're just doing the one direction here, right? So take a breath in, create tension, drive the hands into the floor as if I was trying to flex my wrist into the ground, and then I just shift my body over my wrist, creating more extension while I maintain the contraction, find my end position, and then shift back out of it. If I was gonna do unilateral setup, I'm gonna do one hand at the same time, I would just have one hand here. I could use this hand just for stability, for support. I could kind of go here just to make sure that I'm getting that good contraction from that forearm. But again, take a breath in, full body contraction, drive hand down into the floor. So that's gonna create the contraction on the bottom side of that forearm. I then will just shift my body forward into more extension while I maintain the contraction, find my end position, and then I can use this hand, press me out of it. So the amount of the length of time it takes you to complete each rep, along with the amount of reps, and whether you do a bilateral or unilateral setup, will all be variables that will be dependent on your program, your needs, your goals, and abilities. But that is eccentric neural grooving for wrist extension.